Hello, welcome to the video abstract of the commentary entitled Challenges for Hip Reproduction, Artificial Synthesis or Alternative Natural Sources. My name is Mauro Pavon. I'm from the Program of Glycobiology, Institute of Medical Biochemistry at Federal University of Rio de Janeiro. This work was carried out with the collaboration of Professor Paulo Moron from the same institution. The present commentary is about alternative ways to produce pharmaceutical heparin. Heparin is the main natural anticoagulant used to treat and prevent thromboembolic disorders. The increasing demand for heparin and the recent episodes involving its production call attention to the immediate need to find alternative sources of the glycosaminoglycan. Currently, heparin is obtained almost exclusively from porcine intestine. However, recent studies present alternatives to replace animal heparin, which involves artificial synthesis. I show in Table 1 several heparin analogs obtained from different marine organisms have been described. Some of these compounds have been extensively studied in terms of structure, biological activity, and mechanism of action, and also evaluated in preclinical experiments with promising results. Important aspects to consider about heparin from marine organisms are the very low risk of contamination with pathogens, since they are evolutionarily distant from mammals, the technical and economical possibility to obtain very large quantities of heparin in a constant and ecologically correct manner, and that different species of mollusks and sea cucumbers, including those containing high quantities of heparin analogs, have been successfully cultivated for a long time in different parts of the world. After the outbreak in the late 80s of the bovine spongiform encephalopathy, the commercialization of heparin from bovine tissues has ceased in Europe, United States, and Japan. However, bovine heparin continued to be used clinically in countries from South America, Africa, and Asia, without any reported event on prior contaminations in humans. Pharmaceutical-grade heparin obtained from bovine and porcine intestinal mucosa was shown to be different due to the presence of different proportions of the same mixture of fractions. In other words, the typical disaccharide composition from porcine intestinal heparin with high in vitro anticoagulant activity can be obtained from bovine intestinal mucosa. Therefore, in countries with no economic limitations, bovine tissues may represent a potential alternative source of a higher quality heparin, provided an additional easily performed purification step is introduced in the production. Finally, the real challenge involves the current gold prices of heparin is not to produce a few grams of an artificial heparin, free of contaminants, but how to produce amounts able to respond to an increasing worldwide demand, which tends to increase even more in the future as new therapeutic use of the glycosaminoglycans are being revealed, for example, as an anti-cancer drug. Thus, we believe that alternative animal sources of heparin are a shorter solution than artificial synthesis to respond to the increasing worldwide demand of the glycosaminoglycan.